Rot macht erfinderisch. Musik überwindet zudem jede Grenzanlage.
Just the bed and the clouds. Just on the baseline. It's long, and you could hear the miss hit from the Borg racket. He still hit miss hits the ball, but they go in, Roscoe.
It's unbelievable. I mean, this is the sort of thing that he always did before. He miss hits it, but it lands right on the line. It's very, very frustrating. Some of the fans think maybe the ball was out, but it looked to me like it landed splat right on the line.
Another look here at that last call.
There you can see that ball was just a little bit long.
Now the wind is tricky. It comes and goes. It'll die down, and then suddenly right now it's swirling. And my guess is down on the center court, Roscoe, it's a little bit irregular.
It is. It swirls down there because of the stadium being around the court, so it comes in and sort of twists. But so the players are going to be a little bit confused on some of the balls. They're going to blow wide. They might blow a little, bit long.
Good deep second serve from Bjorn Borg.
And one of the adjustments that Bjorn has made in this game is he shifted to a regular body racket, not a wide body. His racket is very, very thin. It's of the old style. It's not wood, but it's not a big fat racket. That way he feels that his mishits go in a little bit better and he's more solid. He can swing.
Right off the top of that racket you just talked about.
That miss hit won't go in. But that was caused a little bit by the pace of Johan Kriek's return. Here you see it, he just didn't quite keep his eye on the ball. You see, he tried to, but that ball was hit hard. And that's just the reason he missed it. He was a little bit shocked because he had a pretty good serve that it came back so hard.
Just catches the tape, and so Bjorn Borg holds serve. It is 2-1. Borg leading, first set. A warm day out here in Thousand Oaks, California, as we look at the prize money. Total of $150,000. The winner will haul off $40,000, runner up $25,000. You get to the semifinals and finish in third place, $12,500, and the doubles champion, $6,000. Good prize money, Roscoe, and I think that's been the key to the seniors event. Now everybody's really getting serious.
Well, it's made us all get in shape. I mean, everybody's found their jump ropes, and actually a lot of guys, I know I'm using mine now, but it's made everybody realize that, hey, this is something that's gonna happen. It's really gonna be big. It's finally here, and we're excited. It's quite fine. We can't believe it, and it's great.
Kriek serving. Borg's going to have a look at that spot where he thought the ball hit. He just taps it lightly. That's about the most emotion you'll see from Borg. Always a great sport. He really was, wasn't he, through the years, Roscoe? Very few complaints.
Well, his trademark was that he never let something bother him more than that, just that one point. You know, there was a tough call for him, maybe in, maybe out. He lets everybody know that he thought maybe it was wrong.
Right.
But then he goes on.
Kriek opening up with a good approach shot.
He's playing with the wind right now, so he's taking medium-sized swings but getting a lot of pace on the ball, and it's pushing Bjorn way deep in the court. If you notice, Bjorn's standing way, way, way behind the baseline.
Wind coming from behind Johan Kriek. Definitely a factor now.
It makes Bjorn's balls tend to fall short. So Johan can attack.
Just wide.
That was just barely wide. It's always interesting how many linesmen you have in the crowd.
It's wide, and so Kriek holds serve easily. Roscoe, you played Bjorn in that final in 79 at Wimbledon. How has Borg's games changed since that time when you played him?
Well, I think he's doing a lot of the same things, but I think the big thing that he isn't doing as well as he used to is he's a little bit nervous on the big points. So what happens is he always made errors and shanked the balls around at different times in the beginning of sets and beginning of games. But look, out later in the match, he didn't miss. That match last night, the old trademark was back. 6-6 in the tiebreaker in the third set. He came up with 2 great points. So that's a good sign for Bjorn. I really don't care for it, but it's a good sign for him.
Very interesting. Yes, Borg, a fine shot up the line into the wind.
Mm-hmm. Johan played that point just right, and you saw how deep Bjorn is in the court. We'll take a look at it here. Look how far behind the baseline Bjorn is. He whips the ball down the line, and Johan just couldn't quite get to it. But Johan was playing exactly the way he had to.
Good strength there off that Borg forearm. He kind of whipped it up the line, and so Borg, with a smile.
Johan's wondering if that was a let, and Bjorn is going, what? So has a big smile on his face. No, I didn't hear anything.
The umpire will be calling the lets today. There is not a net court judge, and so Creek kind of smilingly said, all right, no lets today. Just why? Bjorn did not like that call.
That looked very, very close to me. We're sitting up here with a great view of that line. Here it comes down. Oh, you can't quite tell. It's hit right where the net strap comes across, but might have been just a little bit wide.
Very tight. Ooh, Creek just catches the tape. So Borg 40-15. You know, you see some smiles and some good-natured stuff out here, Roscoe, but I sense there's a lot of competitiveness on this tour.
Oh, I'll tell you, every guy wants to win. We're having a good time. We're doing what we love to do. So we're gonna smile, but we don't like losing.
Left first serve. Borg going for the flat serve down the center. Oh, yes. Creek knocks off a great return.
That's the way to play Bjorn, too. You've got to go at him early in the point. The longer the point lasts, it seems like the better the passing shot. You can hit a lousy approach shot in the beginning of a point, and he might miss the approach. He sort of settles in into every point.
Just wide.
Ooh, was that close?
Very close again on the sideline. And Bjorn just looks over and smiles again. And so Bjorn Borg. Hold serve, 3-2 Borg, first set. Johan Creek went on to win the first set, 6-4. Let's move ahead now to action later in the second set. Now these guys are going out at 110% now. Big game for both players, 5-4, Borg leading. Bjorn missing again with a forehand.
In that point, and also in the last game, Bjorn's beginning to hit a few one-handed backhands. Sometimes that's when he's getting a bit tentative. And what he's got to do is he's got to keep pressing, keeping Johan off of him. If he starts just floating the backhand back, he's going to be facing a lot of winners coming down his throat.
The wind continuing to come strong from behind Creek. Ooh. Yes.
Another one-handed backhand to fall short.
Not an easy shot. That ball very low. And Creek, as you mentioned, Roscoe, great talent. Just flipped it for a winner.
It's very much like a ping-pong shot. He just flicks it, and all of a sudden, and it goes hard with a lot of spin. And I think that's because of that big, strong forearm and wrist.
And so Johan Creek quickly now to 40 love here. Down 4-5. Creek, as we mentioned, with a win over Guillermo Vilas to move into this match.
Ooh.
Somebody called that ball out. Oh, they're not going to like this. I think even Johan thought that ball was good. He puts it down well inside the baseline, but looks like he'll take the call. And so Creek gets one behind the back. He'll take the call, huh, Roscoe?
And you notice while all that was going on, Bjorn had already gotten the two balls, said, hey, let's get on, let's go with it. And that's the way he is.
Five games all now. Borg serving. Creek with the first set. This is best of three. The winner into the final. Wide.
This game is big. This is where Bjorn's serving against the wind. Johan had great chances last time. 15-40 last time Bjorn served over here. Now he's got love 15. He's in the game.
The shot of the match. Tremendous backhand, Roscoe, down the line.
I'll tell you, this was a great approach shot that Borg hit to come in. He's got that. He's hit it deep. He pummeled it. But Johan Creek from 8 or 9 feet behind the baseline on the full run. Watch this. Meets the ball out in front, stays down with it. Solid. Perfect shot. That's the way it's supposed to be done.
Beautiful replay there. Borg in trouble now. Creek going for the return.
That was a second serve. Big opportunity. Still 15-30, though.
Creek trying to give it a little bit of extra stick.
Yeah, two bad mistakes by Johan. Yeah. Love 30. Bjorn didn't do anything particular spectacular there. Second serve, and he missed the return, and that ball was short.
Borg, big serve when he needs it. Right down the center. And so from love 30 down, Bjorn Borg now at 40-30.
Could use another one of those here.
Deep second serve from Borg. And so Bjorn Borg gets out of trouble once again. Borg leading 6-5, second set. This place really is put together. A beautiful setting here in Thousand Oaks, California. Tremendous turnout. They have sold out today. Johan Creek serving now to the great Bjorn Borg. Creek with the first set. Borg trying to get back in this match. And coming up after this match, we have the number one seed, Jimmy Connors, going against British Davis Cupper, John Lloyd. What a week it's been out here at the Infinity Champions. Love 15.
That was a Creek. Big point for Johan Creek just then, because he had made five straight errors after having love 30 on Bjorn's serve. And if those errors start creeping in, it's trouble.
Oh. Creek just drills another winner.
Bjorn's got to feel like he hit a pretty good shot there to not even get to touch the next ball.
That was not a bad approach shot. 30-15, 40-15 very quickly for Johan Creek. We are 1 point away from a tiebreak.
Ooh. Tight call there.
Double fault.
If they go into the tiebreaker, you begin to wonder which Johan Creek's going to be there, the one that made five straight errors or five straight winners.
Just wide. Creek thought he might have had it.
That's that's two awfully tight calls there from, on first serves for Johan.
Goes long, and so Creek holds serve. It is six games all. We will have a tie break. Johan Creek with the first set, 6-4. Talk about crucial points. Here they come.
Here they come. That's exactly right. And now we'll get to see if Johan can finish it right on out the way he's been playing. He's got to keep going for the shots. That's what he's going to do to win. Is Bjorn going to be like his old self and eliminate all the errors?
Roscoe, what do you think here? Do you think Creek should maybe take some chances and come in behind the second serve in this tiebreak?
I think he's got to do some things. He's there, he plays it a little bit careful, but he still whips the forehand awfully hard. But I think he's got to mix it up. You've got to keep Bjorn guessing as to what you're going to do, because as soon as Bjorn gets comfortable as to how the points are being played, his game lifts. But if you do things to Bjorn in the beginning of points that are just totally different, off the wall, take chances. Chip and come in, rip a return, two different things, and that's what Creek's been doing to perfection today.
1-0 Creek. Johan hits long on the backhand. Bad error, 1 point all.
On the backhand side, every so often he straightens up and hits it straight-legged. When he does that, it sails on him. This point pretty well speaks for itself. That's a great approach shot. Bjorn rips the ball, and look at this. Takes all the pace off of it and hits a drop volley in the tiebreaker against one of the fastest players in the game.
Beautiful shot from Creek. Great hands there. Just came off that little drop volley. So now Johan Creek sensing a chance here against Bjorn Borg. 2-1 Creek.
Because this is on the side. Creek's on the side right now. That's tough for him.
Ooh, a costly double fault from Borg.
And that's coming from the pressure that Johan Creek is putting on him. Johan is taking any short ball, any weak second serve, and drilling it. So Bjorn's got to go for more than he wants to.
There we go again. Oh!
You can hear Creek talking to himself. Big point there for Borg. Excellent first serve, and so Creek now will serve.
Bjorn needs this point bad so that they change ends at 3-all.
Costly backhand error from Borg on a big point. They will change sides. Creek leading 4-2. First player to reach 7 points with a 2-point advantage. We'll win this set 7-6. If it's Creek, he will have won the match. Borg quickly over. Roscoe didn't even hesitate.
I think he's a little bit upset with himself for that last return. He's a second serve and he stood there flat-footed.
He didn't get around and move his feet. It's like he was a little uncertain as to what he wanted to do with that ball. Because anything he's done, Johan has stepped up and whipped it for a winner. So, ooh, that serve almost hit the baseline.
4-2 Creek. And another miss hit off the forehand from Borg. It almost dropped in the corner in spite of the miss hit.
It did. The wind almost caught that and dropped it in. And the linesman almost called that ball out before it landed. It was a lot closer than he planned on it being.
And so now Borg in big trouble, down 2-5. Creek 2 points away from a big upset. The two-hander catches the net, and so now Bjorn Borg down 4 match points.
in tough position.
Sexton Creek. Ooh.
Yeah, this is tough.
Johan Creek nails the forehand. And so Johan Creek has done it. A standing ovation for Johan Creek. Tremendous tennis from this gentleman from Naples. And so Johan Creek has defeated the great Bjorn Borg in straight sets, 6-4, 7-6.
Johan, that was one heck of a match.
Thank you, Oscar. Yeah, I played pretty well today.
Jeez, I mean, we were counting up winner after winner after winner with almost no unforced errors, but 13 aces on your serve.
Well, you know, I've been really worried about my serve because I haven't played very many matches except for maybe team tennis and a couple of doubles events. And so I had no idea how I was going to serve in a singles match. So, you know, every match I played here, I seemed to improve on my serve, and today everything clicked.
I tell you, you don't need to work on it anymore. And next week when we play doubles together, just keep serving that way.
I'll remember.
But what was today, it seemed like your strategy was really to come at Bjorn and really go after him early.
Well, I knew if I served well, I would have my confidence level pretty high, so I could go for my ground strokes a little bit more because I'm winning more free points. And it worked out well for me today. I came in on a lot of shots and, you know, didn't hit many volleys, actually. I served so well that I never really got a volley. So.
Well, I'll tell you, another question that we want to know from all the players. It's the Champions Tour. It's brand new. It's starting. By the judgment of the crowd and everybody else, it's a huge success. How do the players feel about it?
Well, I think it's going to be a great success. I can't wait for next year when we have maybe 8 to 10 events and really put us on the map. I think by the looks of the last two, this event and last week's, I mean, it's going to be fantastic. And I think the people really appreciate the type of tennis we play because we're still out here hitting the ball as hard as we ever could. And, you know, I think it's going to be a great success.
Well, it was exciting to me to watch you play today, and I'll be hoping I won't have to play against you at all. But anyway, it was great. Congratulations. Good luck tomorrow against whoever you face. Back to you, Barry.
All right, Roscoe, a very happy Johan Creek. As we look at match point, the big forehand comes over the ball. He knows he's won it. Johan Creek, an upset winner in straight sets over Bjorn Borg. And don't forget, coming up, Jimmy Connors, the number one seed, will be going against John Lloyd. We'll have it for you. We'll be back. Our second semifinal coming right up. Jimmy Connors, the number one seed, going against British Davis Cupper, John Lloyd. And hello again, everybody. Barry McKay with Roscoe Tanner. And Roscoe, what a match that semifinal was. Johan Creek playing about as well as I've seen him play ever. Great match for him.
Oh, he was unbelievable. He was serving aces all over the place. And then when Bjorn did get the ball back, he took his forehand and was rifling winners. And then I think he tried some new shots that he's never tried with his backhand and put those away, too.
Well, he played some great tennis. And now we've got a match coming up, Jimmy Connors against John Lloyd. Roscoe, you've played against Jimmy for many years. What makes him such a tremendous tennis player?
Well, I think he's technically perfect. He's the guy that when you're teaching somebody, you want him to copy. He gets down low to the ball. He's always prepared. He's moving. He's always anticipating the shots. He's always right on top of you, and he fights to the end.
He's a great competitor, no question about that. Well, he's taking on John Lloyd. Lloyd playing some excellent tennis. He's been active all summer. Maybe comes in here as one of the sharpest players on the tour.
Well, I think John may be playing the best tennis of his whole life. He's much more confident. He believes he should win now, and that's a big difference. When he was playing the regular tour, he was a little uncertain of himself. But now he's really playing well. His ground strokes are strong and aggressive. His serve is good, but he's going to need to really vary his serve and keep Jimmy off of him tonight. Otherwise, Jimmy's going to attack and really hurt him.
All right, that's our matchup. And let's have a look now and see how these two players reach the semifinals in the draw here. Up on top, of course, the number one seed, Connors, got a bye, then played Larry Steffanke to move into the semifinals. On the bottom half, John Lloyd, a fine win there over Vitas Gerulaitis, who can play some excellent tennis. Gerulaitis was seeded fourth. And so that gives you some idea of how these players moved into this semifinal round. Jimmy Connors out warming up, hitting some volleys there, and certainly looks sharp, Roscoe.
He does. If you watch, he's always got the racket early. He's meeting the ball out in front. There's a shot I haven't seen him hit too often. But he's constantly moving. He's not standing still. See, in between shots, even when he's warming up right now, he's keeping the racket out in front. He's not a big guy, but he gets an awful lot of pace through preparation.
Look at the details there. 41 years old, just under 6 feet tall, 155 pounds. He's been at that weight for a long time and lives just up the road here in Santa Ynez, California. A tremendous career there, Roscoe. 109 wins. It may never be broken.
I don't know who's going to break it if anybody does. I mean, somebody's going to have to start awfully young because he did.
And so Connors takes some last-minute warm-ups on this center court. He is ready to go. The number one seed, his opponent tonight, John Lloyd, who is playing, as you said, Roscoe, about as well as he's played in his entire career.
He really is a confident player right now. I think he may not have that much confidence against Jimmy Connors, I'm not sure, but he really can do very many things very well. He's quick, he's in good shape. You see, he's 39 years old, he's 6 feet, 185 pounds, he's strong, he hits the ball hard. He meets the ball out in front, too. He trains very, very hard. He's done some coaching, he's played team tennis, he's done a bunch of things. He really is playing very well right now.
As you look at John's career earnings, over $650,000, ranked number 21. And we had a chance to catch up with John Lloyd, and we asked him, hey, John, what do you really think about Jimmy Connors' tennis game?
Well, Jimmy Connors, probably the best return of server in the game. Even now, amongst the regular players, I would put him on a par with Andre Agassi in that respect. One of the great competitors of all time, and just hates to lose more than any player I think that I've ever played against or ever seen. A great, great player.
And so John Lloyd, obviously knowing exactly what he's facing tonight in this youngster, Jimmy Connors, no youngster anymore, but certainly one of the all-time great players in the game. As we watch Jimmy Connors warm up, both players being introduced out here on this center court. And Roscoe, I think a lot of anticipation in the air here tonight because people know that John Lloyd is certainly capable of causing some real trouble in this tournament.
Well, and earlier today they saw an upset that nobody thought was going to happen, and so anything can happen. We've got a sellout again tonight. It's perfect weather. It's absolutely perfect. It's not too hot, not too cold, no wind, and they do. They have probably the two of the sharpest players that came to this tournament because they've been playing competitive tennis more often than anybody else right now, and they've been practicing together. They're on the same team, tennis team, so they've been practicing together, and there's your umpire, Jan Ryan, going to be controlling this match. But these guys know exactly what each other does and what they have to do to win. And John maybe, you know, he could have a little bit of uncertainty about him because Jimmy is awfully tough.
Connors now getting a tremendous ovation from this crowd here as he is introduced. A look there at how he reached the semifinals. This is a 16 draw. The first four players seated get a bye in the first round, and then he beat Larry Stefanke, who is certainly playing well. John Lloyd with a win over Marty Reesen, one of the veterans on the tour, and then certainly an upset over Vitas Gerulaitis, who I think a lot of people feel will certainly be a threat on this tour as it moves along, Roscoe.
Well, Vitas is playing better and better, and he's been working on his tennis. He's beginning to hit the ball a lot sharper, and he's going to be a dangerous player, particularly next year when there's 8 to 10 tournaments. He's going to get match sharp, and he wants to play well. He's been playing some great golf too, but he wants to play tennis again. And I think every guy on the tour is excited that all the other guys are coming and starting to practice more, and everybody's getting better. So I think that's one of the exciting things.
Jimmy Connors, a look at career singles titles. Of course, Connors way out in front, 109. Lendl not bad at 92. And we are underway here. First game, first set. This is best of three. The winner will move into the final to take on Johan Kriek. Connors serving in the first game, and certainly, Roscoe, you mentioned the conditions now much more ideal. No wind, virtually no wind out here, as there was earlier in the Kriek-Borg match. Well, if any two players know each other's games, these two do. They were teammates on the Los Angeles team tennis a year or so ago, and they've played a lot of tennis against each other in practice.
In practice together. They've been together probably for the last couple of months. They also this year were on the Phoenix team tennis team, and they really do know each other. They warm up in most of the time. I imagine they didn't warm up together tonight. But they really know each other's games. And I think that's really helped John get sharper and sharper. He's playing with Jimmy all the time.
30-15, Connor serving. First game, first set. would you say, Roscoe, of any of the shots of Connors, maybe the forehand slightly suspect?
The forehand is the one that he'll have a tendency to cut too fine and hit the net with. One of the memorable matches in the past was when Manolo Orantes played him in the finals of the U.S. Open, and Jimmy missed a lot of forehands in the net.
Yeah, he normally misses into the net, not over the baseline.
Right.
Boy, trying to rifle off that high backhand overhead, hits it wide, and so Connors now with game point.
And Jimmy's a very smart player there. I mean, John comes in, they're playing at night under the lights. So what does he do? He throws up a lob. Why try to blister a passing shot when the lob be up there? When you think of the technical part of strategy, the technical part of preparing and mental things, Jimmy just makes no errors in those areas.
Second serve. Good solid return from John Lloyd.
And that's what John's got to do. He's got to take his chances. He's got to step into Jimmy's serve, because Jimmy doesn't really try to overpower you with the serve. And matter of fact, each one of Jimmy's shots don't necessarily overpower you, but you link them all together and you've been running quite a bit.
And Lloyd quickly in, knocks off the volley. This is what John Lloyd said he would have to do, Roscoe, in order to beat Connors tonight, and a good example of it right there.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. He's got to charge anytime he can get a chance, but he's got to keep Jimmy on the run. If you don't hit him too much on the run, you're gonna get passed.
Chance for Lloyd to break here, first game. And Connors misses a backhand volley, and John Lloyd has broken serve in the first game of the first set. John Lloyd leading, one love, first set. Center court action, second semifinal, as Jimmy Connors, the number one seed, taking on his fine British former Davis Cupper, John Lloyd. Lloyd with an early break, leading one love in the first set, will now serve in the second game of the first set. Yes.
John plays a great point right there, and the thing that's going to happen is that we're going to see whether or not he can do that over and over and over.
Just long. Lloyd going for a very flat serve down the middle. Just long. And Roscoe, you were a big server. When you get an early break in a set like this, don't you think, as a good server, which Lloyd is, really, really gives you a lot of confidence to perhaps win the set?
Gives you a big lift. From Jimmy's point of view, though, he's thinking, I do serve a lot. He likes to break serve back. And so John's got to watch out for that. But it certainly is helping John feel good about it. He's on the board. He's not nervous now. And he can go ahead and take his shots with his serve and move it around.
John Lloyd settling in quickly here, 40 love up, second game. And Lloyd uncorks a very deep first serve. And so John Lloyd quickly to a 2-love lead over the number one seed, Jimmy Connors. Connors winning that inaugural event. Roscoe, about a month ago back in Columbus, Ohio.
Right, at the Big Bear Champions in New Albany. And it was on clay courts, whereas this is on a medium-paced hard court. But Jimmy played awfully well back there. He beat Bjorn Borg in the finals.
Good try from Lloyd. The ball would go wide. Connors always with a solid overhead, Roscoe.
He really gets in position well for it, keeps the ball in front of him. A couple of those lobs were up over the lights, which should have been difficult, and he didn't have any problem with it at all. John Lloyd actually was in the semifinals in that tournament back in Ohio and barely lost in three sets to Bjorn Borg. So John has been playing very well.
Talked about the tour. Look at the point standings after that first event. Jimmy Connors with 400 leads Borg with 250. Lloyd very close, tied with Peter Fleming, John McEnroe's old doubles partner, at number three. And to look at how the points are earned, so it's a tight race.
It is a tight race, and the top six will advance to that final at the MGM Grand in January of '95, where you get $100,000 to the winner. So we're all pointing for it.
Lloyd, I think, said stay down on that ball. He came over it.
That's what happens, the barrage of Jimmy's shots. It's just like no single one bothers you, but you just keep having it. Keeps on you, keep, and that you, there's this trouble shots all the time, and it's what you start to get a little jumpy, and you start jumping on the shots, you don't stay down, and you technically break down, and Jimmy never does.
Ooh, Connors just hits the tape on a low forehand volley. Lloyd returning very well, though, Roscoe, at this point.
It's one of the strong points of his game. He's aggressive with the return. If you watch, he generally meets it out in front. He's active with his feet, and so he gets a good hit at the returns almost all the time.
Connors still with game point, trying to get on the board here in the first set. Down, love two. No call. Lloyd calls it good. And so Connors serves up his first ace of the evening. It is 2-1, Lloyd leading first set. Due to time constraints, we cannot show you this entire match. Let's move ahead now to action later in the first set. Connors with a little smile there. He should be smiling. He was down 2-love, has come back with 3 straight games as John Lloyd prepares to serve in the 6th game. A look at first serve percentages. Connors extremely well there at 78%, Roscoe.
I tell you, it's a great percentage for John Lloyd, too, at 58%, because he's been going for an awful lot with his serve.
Just long.
But Jimmy's always had a big percentage of first serves in. And he, what he does, he just moves it around. He doesn't really go for a whole lot with any specific shot, particularly his serve. Every so often, he'll go for the ace, just to keep you honest. But basically, he gets it in play, and then he's just going to work you over. John's got to go for a bit more, and 58% while you're going for it, it's pretty good.
Connors definitely finding the range, as you said, Roscoe.
Mm-hmm.
Leaning into that return now.
He is. He's beginning to sort of guess where John's going to serve. John isn't fooling him right now, and Jimmy's making John have to come up with unbelievable volleys or not get to the volley at all.
No question about it. Connors walks over. First ace of the evening for John Lloyd.
Oops. The ball kids get so excited there. They trip.
You heard Jimmy yell, missed it. He knew the minute he... That's great. Telling the linesman, hey, I called it. You don't have to worry about that. It was out.
Yeah.
A
The Roscoe players know the minute they hit the ball whether that baby's going in or out. Isn't that true?
They do, and it's as soon as you hit it, you also, when the other guy hits it quite often, you know whether or not you're even getting the point.
And Lloyd missing. There's one of those lobs that went very high.
That one was noticeably deeper than the other ones he's hit too, but that one carried very deep into the court, and it got up just a little bit above the lights. Makes it very difficult for John to really punch it, and he knew he had to punch it or he was dead on the next ball.
Lloyd still with game point here, 40-30. Oh, yes. Ball bouncing nice and high right into the two-hander.
Jimmy likes that high one. A lot of guys on the backhand side don't like to have to return a high ball. But Jimmy, with his two hands, gets up there and he can control it and drill it right back down at you. You watch Jimmy on the returns, too, where he stands. He stands a good deal behind the baseline, but as he goes to hit the ball, he's angling forward. Just another one of the technical things that he does that everybody tries to teach.
It's going to go wide. So John Lloyd now with a chance to get even at three games all. Let that two love lead slip away. It really didn't let it slip away. Connors came back very strong to break.
Mm-hmm. Jimmy's come up with better and better shots. Another second serve in the ad court. John's going to have to come up with a very good volley here.
No, it's long. And so John Lloyd holds serve, a tough game. Three games all.
It was a good play by John Lloyd to stay back that time. He'd been coming in on his second serve over and over and gotten past. This time he gave a look like he was going to come in, stayed back, and Jimmy kind of took his eye off the ball a little bit, and that's why his return floated.
Just wide. We have reached the crucial seventh game, Roscoe, that we talked about earlier. Usually the swing game of most sets.
This is a big game, because if John can win this, he can be serving ahead 4-3. Really feel like he's got a little bit of a momentum going.
Oh, yes. And Connors making a great decision, Roscoe, because that ball was floating in for sure on the sideline here.
It was. A lot of people would have tried to let that go and wish, but Jimmy Connors is not a guy to wish on anything. He makes sure it happens and made a great volley there.
What a big shot that was, because, as you said, a lot of guys might have let that ball go.
And it looked like
it was coming in for sure. Catches the net.
It's interesting, in that point, Jimmy got caught a little bit.
You know I only cover the line.
That's great. Connors and Lloyd have played so much against each other. Connors saying, hey, I always cover the line.
But he did get caught on that a little bit and ended up hitting a one-handed backhand. It's a little surprising.
Missing with the two-hander, hates that, and so now John Lloyd with a big opportunity here in the seventh game. Break point. Smiles are gone.
That's right. No jokes on this point. This is a big one.
That's a great point. Best point of the match, Roscoe. Connors using all the court that time.
He was. That down wide lob. John just couldn't quite get around enough. I mean, he had it on the backhand side, so John couldn't get over and hit a forehand and really tried to do an overhead on it. Instead, he had to keep just trying to ball back, and Jimmy was just owning him and really didn't ever let John into the point and be able to hit his shot.
Connors using the lob a lot tonight. Just over the baseline. Ooh, we may have a correction. No, I thought I heard a correction from the umpire.
Yeah, it was pretty close, that ball. But Jimmy uses the lob probably better than anybody else. And I think a lot of that comes from some of his work with Segura in the back. And you know, back in the old days, because Segura really was a master at strategy and using the lob.
Another big chance for Lloyd here. Break point. He's on it. And John Lloyd has broken serve in the crucial seventh game. Lloyd leading 4-3, first set.
Now we're seeing two types of Jimmy Connors backhands. The first one we're going to see is going to be flat. Look at his footwork, though. Watch how he gets the racket back early. The ball's not even in the picture yet, but his racket is ready now. Now comes the ball. He's down low, moving forward into it. Now you see how he comes up and through the ball. That's a flat one. That's picture perfect. Look at those feet. Now he's ready for the next shot. Now we're going to see the other one. Here he is. He's down low again. This is what makes it deceptive. Now the racket comes above, down through the ball, slides it down the line, but he's ready again. Preparation always with Connors.
Those were two great shots, Roscoe. The footwork just perfect. A look at the net points here. Connors in pretty good shape, but Lloyd has really been in a lot.
That's what he said he was going to have to do, and that's why he's in there in the match.
Connors down a break, having some fun here.
Be interesting to see here. Jimmy Connors has changed rackets. He's gone from the pink one to the yellow one. I don't know what the difference is, but it's definitely probably a different string job. I imagine the rackets match exactly.
And a double fault starts off the game for Lloyd. His first double fault of the evening, and a bad time for it, Roscoe. He's got the break. He's got it going.
It's what they always say after you break. You really want to focus strong on the first 2 points when you serve to get off to a good start in that game. Otherwise, it can make a lot of trouble.
Ooh, just over the baseline. A few whistles.
Boy, that that baselineman back there has got a rough job. Those balls are all over. Right beside it.
Jimmy telling John it was slightly over the baseline. Let first serve. Ooh, he could have used an ace right there, Roscoe.
He needed it at left 30. Would have helped.
Connors hitting one of the best approach shots he's hit all night off that two-hander that time.
He has got it good and deep, but he set it up basically with that return. He hit the return very deep. John Lloyd tried to have volley. It didn't get pushed back, but then he had to hit a short ball, and Jimmy was all over it.
Three chances now for Connors. Triple break point. Love 40. Jimmy trying to get back even at four games all. A look at break points there. Goes long, and so Jimmy Connors has broken at love. Big opportunity slides away from John Lloyd. Four games all. First set. Roscoe, they've talked so often of that great, what everybody calls the class of 1952. Jimmy Connors was one of those players. You were in that group, but what a group of players it was. Eric Van Dillen,
Sandy Mayer. Yeah. and Eddie Dibbs, Harold Solomon, Dickie Stockton, and there was a number, also Brian Gottfried, who's the ATP tennis director.
Tremendous There's, group.
And Raul Ramirez, the list goes on. It's a big group.
Connors jumping all over the two-hander now.
And all those guys in that group are eligible.
This tour could get very tough very quick.
Sure could.
Connors choosing just the right ball here. They're changing it 7 and 9 games, so these balls are fairly new. They've only been used one game. Oh, yes.
That's a great return of serve at just the right time. He needed that. Because Jimmy can run strings of points together pretty quickly if you don't. And John came up with a big shot at the right time. Slows things down just a bit for John.
Trying to do just a bit too much with the forehand, pulls it wide.
I was surprised all through that point how deep he was keeping the ball, because Jimmy doesn't like to stay pinned to that baseline. He likes to be on the baseline a little in front of it. When he's pinned behind it, John's keeping the ball as much as he can within a foot or so of the baseline. That's awfully tough to do on a regular basis, but it's what he's going to have to do, and he can. See what happens.
Connors coming on strong now, has won 6 of the last 7 points. Tremendous two-hander from Jimmy Connors deep into the forehand court of John Lloyd. So Connors now at 40-15 trying to close out this game. And a bit too much on the volley.
A huge game for John Lloyd. He's really played quite well. I don't know if he can play a whole lot better in this set. And if Jimmy gets ahead 5-4.
Good quality tennis, as you mentioned, Roscoe. So different from the match we saw earlier with Creek and Borg. These guys seem to be hitting the ball a lot crisper.
They are hitting crisper. They seem just a touch sharper.
Oh, yes, a great play by Lloyd, but a better shot by Connors. And so Jimmy Connors holds serve. 5-4, Connors leading first set. A sold-out house, 3,100 strong, as John Lloyd prepares to try and stay in this first set against Jimmy Connors, who has come back very strong. Connors was down 2-love. And now Lloyd serving at 4-5 in the first set.
John really needs to have a high percentage of first serves this game and moving them around. Because Jimmy's going to come at him strong. This is right where Jimmy likes to get going.
Oh, just long. Connors just about ready to try and volley that ball. Wisely let it go long.
One time I remember I was practicing with Jimmy at his ranch in Santa Ynez. And he was saying sometimes that he'd rather be returning for the set than serving for the set.
It looked like it on that point, didn't it?
He gets awfully aggressive with the return.
Great approach. Maybe the yellow racket is to his liking, Roscoe.
He's played well ever since he got it.
Yes, he has. Love 15, second serve now for Lloyd. Connors continuing to keep the pressure on that return of serve.
No.
is where John was on the run all the way through this point. Jimmy hits a pretty good approach, but doesn't get as deep as he wants to. John's right there. That was the first opportunity that John Lloyd had to win that point. Jimmy had him on the rope all the way around.
Connors did everything exactly as he planned it. Too good a forehand from Lloyd, 15 all. Looked like he might have pulled something as he came in behind that shot. Ooh. I don't know, Roscoe, it looked to me like for a second Jimmy might have pulled something, either an ankle or something went as he came in behind the two-hander.
He definitely hesitated just a second there, and that's not normally his style.
Yes, he did.
He may have wondered, trying to mean hesitating as to deciding whether or not he was going to go in, but it did look a little bit strange there.
30-15. Again, the Connors lob, perfect control.
Well, and you know, the biggest thing about it, he's hitting it with that backhand, and what happens is he gets that racket back early, he's down low, he doesn't look up, so he doesn't telegraph that he's going to hit a lob. So you have a tendency to want to lean forward and cover that blistering passing shot he might hit, and he lobs over you. And if you lean back, he hits a little angle. What do you do? Tell me these guys aren't trying.
Boy, this is a great match. Himself. Roscoe, this quality of tennis right here has been tremendous this first set. Both players hitting the ball very cleanly, moving well. And now John Lloyd with a chance to even this set at 5 games all. Just catches the tape, and so John Lloyd gets out of trouble. Hold serve. We'll be back with more from the Infinity Champions right after this.
You're watching.
They're running. There's a lot of running going on, and they're hitting the ball hard all the way through. Nobody's laying off anything. They're going at each other.
Yep. Change of directions, and very impressive. 10 games thus far. Connor serving, 5 games all. Look at those lights we've talked about way up high there. Again, the lob.
That's awfully, it's awfully tiring, it's awfully wearing to constantly be jumping up trying to hit a backhand overhead. It's the weakest shot you can possibly have because there's no strength anywhere to punch it. And so you're constantly really having to strain hard. So Jimmy's making John work. John's in good shape, so he can handle it, but he's making him work.
Roscoe, you've seen Connors play an awful lot. Do you think he has used the lob thus far maybe a bit more than he normally does?
I think so. I think he knows that John Lloyd comes in fast and likes to come in and run straight at the net and then punch one off. This will back him up.
Good slider serve from Connors. And so Jimmy goes quickly to 30 love here, 5 games all.
Jimmy mixes it up very well. If he senses that you're getting ready for that lob, then you don't see the lob. All of a sudden you get a little angle.
Pickup volley by John Lloyd. Connors hit a fine shot there.
He did hit a great shot, and John's just moving so well. He's all over the court, and John is playing as well as I've ever seen him play in his whole life. And I think it's great to see. He's playing with an awful lot of confidence, and he's hanging in there. He's got chances.
Connors opens up with one of his biggest serves of the night, and what a time for it. puts him up 40-15.
So a little concentration lapse from Jimmy Connors. Yeah. You don't see too many of those, so take note of that. You may not see it again for a while.
Jimmy's starting to talk to himself after missing some first serves here. Good approach shot, a little short.
A little bit sluggish on that. He's not moving quite as well as he was a little earlier. He needs to pick up the pace again. Maybe he's playing a little bit. It just seemed to be like he maybe got a little bit winded. He may have played a lapse of concentration shot, sort of slapped one along. And then that one, he really didn't play quite as sharp as he has been. It's a good opportunity for John. That was not the time to make an unforced error.
Yeah. Lloyd had come back strong to get into this game, and Connors now with a chance to go up 6-5. Play from both players, and Connors holds serve. Connors 6-5. Earlier today, Johan Kriek upset Bjorn Borg. He is in the finals waiting to see who wins this match. John Lloyd at the bottom of your picture, Jimmy Connors at the top. Lloyd serving first set 5-6. Well, Jimmy's percentage has fallen off slightly, but that's still pretty tough. Oh, yes.
John Lloyd's going to feel like he's at a track meet. And if he misses that first serve, Jimmy steps in. And one of the things that Jimmy does so well, not only does he hit it aggressively, but he hits it far away from you. So you've got a long way to run to get to the ball, and then the whole court's open the other direction.
Just long. Connors going for the passing shot down the line.
That's definitely a passing shot that he's not used to missing.
Yeah.
He didn't like missing that ball at all. Because that's his bread and butter, that down the line backhand.
15 all.
Yeah, he had it perfectly set up with a couple of cross courts. Off the first point of the game, Jimmy hit that same ball over there, and John got it back, and then Jimmy rifled it to the other corner, so John knows he's got to run about 8 miles, so he starts to run, and he wrong foots him right behind him.
15-30 now. Big chances here for Connors. He would love to close this out and avoid a tiebreak. Second serve.
John played that very smart. Let that ball bounce, took his time, and hit it a long way away from Jimmy. Let Jimmy do a little bit of the running.
Connors very smartly now trying to get a little extra time before he receives. Get some wind.
I John's hitting the net an awful lot with his first serve, and he mentioned to himself, he's pulling down. He's not really letting himself extend through the ball. As a result, it's pulling it down in the net.
And again, Connors jumping all over that second serve, cuts off the angle. And so Jimmy Connors now with set point. And there it is, Connors pulling the two-hander cross court. Great timing.
You see, Jimmy's taking a little break here.
Connors.
That was a tough game they just had.
He knows he has played some tennis, Roscoe. I'll tell you, that was really good stuff. And so Connors, with a lot of touch on that little two-hander, wins the first set, 7-5. No change. Connors will serve. First game, second set.
It's a big point. John needs to get off to a good start in this set. If he can get this game like he did in the first set, he's got some good chances, but he's got to stick with Jimmy. If he lets Jimmy drift out to a lead, he's got a big problem. Shows how John's been training quite a bit. He's been working. He's never out of a point. He can be on the dead run, but he recovers very well, gets himself back in there. And Jimmy is keeping him on the dead run all over the court. But John's working and working and saving some points that he wouldn't ordinarily get because he's in good shape. He's been training hard.
Though by Lloyd, even though he missed it, Roscoe, Jimmy knows that he may be trying to come in a bit now.
And it was interesting because before he's always tried to rifle it with a little bit of topspin or flat. There he was going to chip and charge. He was coming under it, hitting it soft, sort of low and short, and coming in. It would have been a tough one for Jimmy. He'd have to run forward and do something.
That first serve. I wonder what's running through Lloyd's mind, Roscoe. He played a fine first set, as you said, maybe some of the best tennis you've ever seen him play. Loses it in a very close battle, but what's going through his mind right now? Can he change anything? And Connors giving 3,100 people a thrill. One love, second set. Due to time constraints, we cannot show you this entire match. Let's move ahead now to action later in the second set. Lloyd serving, down 3-4. Connors with the first set, 7-5. Called a fault. Again, Connors using the lob as he checks where that ball dropped. Very close.
Boy, that ended up being close. John was on a string there, I believe, of winning 8 straight points.
Yeah.
And Jimmy, there, all of a sudden, he concentrated a little bit better than he did the other game.
Great deception on that two-handed lob by Connors. Lloyd down, love 15, and down 3-4. Thank you. Oh, yes, Connors looked like he was going up the line and then hits cross court.
Yeah, he prepared just like he was going to go up the line, but that's what he can do with that two-handed shot. He can be so deceptive and change at the last second. And John Lloyd's practiced with him all this time and thought he was going up the line, too.
Love 30. Chances now for Connors. Ball sticks in the net.
John grabs his bicep there saying he's so strong he stuck it in the net.
Oh yes, Connors just jumps all over the second serve. And so now Connors turns it around very quickly. Three break points for Jimmy Connors to go up 5-3.
Mm-hmm. When you're serving at a point like this, and you're down love 40 on your serve facing Jimmy Connors' return, you feel like you're in a pretty big hole.
And again, Connors drills the return, and Lloyd loses serve at love. Connors will serve for the match, 5-3. And we have had three straight love games, Roscoe. Amazing.
That's right.
8 points for Lloyd.
Two of them against serve.
Yeah. Good little drop shot
totally
by Connors.
Totally surprised John, because if you watch John's feet during that point, right as Jimmy hit the drop shot, John actually took two steps backwards. He thought the ball was going to go deep.
Good. Oh, Connors tries a very tricky little drop volley.
Here he comes in, and he just kind of takes his eye off of it a little bit. If he'd met that a little bit more in front, it would have gone over. But he just let it get behind him a little bit.
All the body English in the world couldn't get that one over.
That's from playing golf. Jimmy's been playing some golf. He's used to doing that.
15 all. A good serve out wide from Connors.
It's been right on the corner, that serve. That was a very, very deep.
Connors now 2 points away from this match and a berth in the final.
The great thing about John's hanging in there. He's not giving up, and he's working, because he's only still just down one break. If he breaks serve right here, they're back on serve in this set.
He is making Connors work very hard in this game. 30 all. Jimmy taking a lot of extra time now. This is what Connors does so well. Senses the moment
and he spreads it out.
Yeah. Continues to hit cross court. Mm-hmm. I thought for sure, Roscoe, he was going up the line on that two-hander.
Well, and the thing about it is he prepares so well, prepares so early, and he's sitting there with the racket back, so he doesn't give anything away. He can totally disguise it up until the time he's swinging. So if he chooses the right one, you have no prayer of getting to it.
And Connors up the line, a solid shot. And Jimmy Connors, a solid match from both sides as he wins in straight sets, 7-5 and 6-3. He is now courtside with Roscoe Tanner. Roscoe?
Barry, I'm down here with Jimmy. Congratulations, Jimmy. That was a great match.
Well, I had to. You know, when Lloydy came out and played like that, he started off the first game and made a lot of good shots and then served well. I thought he served particularly well because I was returning the ball as well as I ever have. And his ground strokes, everybody's ground strokes are improving now. So it's good fun for me to come down here and play. But to play a match like that, that's just what I really look for.
Well, up there watching, it just seemed like John was serving very, very well. He was moving the ball around. He's serving out wide particularly well. But you kept closing in and making him hit his first volley right off his shoelaces.
Well, that's what I've always been able to do, Roscoe, and to keep putting the pressure on him. But the first set, he just kept coming back with great shots. He was up a break first, and then I went up a break, and it was back and forth in the first set. But if I can keep the ball down low, eventually I'm going to have a chance to hit a passing shot. And then in the one game that I did break for the set, he missed two shots, which was uncharacteristic of his first set play.
Right. It just seemed like over time he just kept wearing and wearing and wearing on him, keeping the pressure on him, and take your opportunities.
Well, that's what I need to do most of all, is if I have an opportunity to break, I have to really jump on it now and take advantage of it. And, you know, with all the guys, everybody's out there working and getting in better shape and going about their tennis the way we've always gone about it throughout the course of our career. So I better play well.
Well, you know what? It's exciting for me to see you do that to someone else besides me.
We've had too many matches, but the good thing about it is we're going to have a lot more. And as long as the people come out and support the events and we have the guys putting forth their efforts like they're doing, we're going to have a good time.
That's right. It makes us all feel like a bunch of young kids again.
Well, we are young. Don't ever forget that. Okay. I hope they don't either.
Okay. Well, congratulations.
Thanks,
back to you, Barry.
All right, Roscoe, a very happy Jimmy Connors on a beautiful night here. A winner moving into the finals, 7-5 and 6-3. And so Jimmy Connors will play Johan Kriek tomorrow. And so for Roscoe Tanner, I'm Barry McKay saying so long, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow from Thousand Oaks.
On filthy oil. It will do it on blood.
When it's got to be clean, trust Ariel.
At last, this is what you game fans wanted. Double value games. With double value games, you get two classic games packaged together in one brilliant pack at an unbelievably low price. There's 13 kicking packs with 26 fabulous Sega games on Mega Drive, Master System, and Game Gear. With two great games in each pack, you've got to be the winner. Double the value, double the fun. It's like the greatest hits of Sega.
All you need to start earning membership miles points is an American Express card. Pick up a leaflet for more details.
From the Sky Satellite Network.
College for women?